Hey YouTube, this is Chris Camaro bringing you a playthrough of Soma. This commentary follows two other great games by Frictional Games, Penumbra and Amnesia. And if any of you have played those games, you'll know they were excellent survival horror games, and this game promises to live up to the expectations set by those standards. I've already set the game up in terms of like getting all my key bindings and my video and all that together. I've got an AMD FX 6300 with 6 cores, 8 gigs of RAM, two R9 270 video cards, and a Creative X5 sound card. So, not too bad of a rig, not top of the line, but certainly nothing to sneeze at. So, hopefully, this will be a good playthrough for all of you. And because this game is such a cerebral and immersive game, I'm gonna go through it very slowly, very carefully, and try to comment on it only when it's necessary or when it's appropriate, so that you guys can really get pulled into the atmosphere and really feel the game the way I'm gonna be feeling it. Because this is my first playthrough, and the first time through a game is always a very special one, and you can never really get that back. So my reactions are gonna be very spontaneous and very natural, and hopefully that enhances the game experience for you. So, without further ado, let's get right into it. If you saw that little message, I didn't really play the game. I just started it up just to make sure that nothing was broken. But I haven't played any of it yet, so should be pretty good. Here you've got that quote that they put on their website.
Are you okay, Simon? I think you're bleeding.
Oh, that's nothing. It's just my brain can't stop bleeding from the accident.
Here, take this.
No, that's for later, for the scan.
It's green.
Ashley, I need to tell you something.
Simon, please don't make this weird.
No, it's not like that. Why now?
Who's David Lynch?
Why is there never enough time?
For what?
Yeah, that's me.
My name is David Munchie. We spoke earlier.
The brain scan, I remember.
Are you all right?
Yeah, just a bad dream. Are we still on for today?
Yeah, that's why I'm calling. I wanted to remind you to drink the tracer fluid I sent you. It'll help me capture a better image of the damages.
Don't worry, I got it somewhere.
Okay, great. Well, I'll see you in a couple of hours then.
Okay, see you soon.
So, based on the intro cutscene, it looks like this guy, the protagonist that I'm playing, had some sort of an accident or something, and he's suffered some head injuries, and now he's got to go in for a brain scan with a doctor. So my first task is to find this tracer fluid that he was talking about on the phone there. Which I guess you drink it, and it shows up on an X-ray so that they can see what's wrong with you, what's wrong with your brain or whatever, right? The physics system in this game works just the same as it does in Amnesia. Everything's very
Where did the tracer fluid?
it's very natural. You can reach into the world and pick things up and spin them around, and adds a new level of realism, because most games just sort of have the system where you just click and it opens a door or something like that, but this is very involved. Bunch of memorabilia. Looks like
Come
we're in his
on, we lack the
apartment.
tracer fluid. Where are you?
Might help me find it if I turn some lights
Thunder's
on.
coming. I hope it's a good one. Fast food. So buy something healthier on my way home.
swear, that guy has the memory of a goldfish.
I even sent an email to remind him, didn't I?
I don't know, did you? Blah blah blah, the scan will be performed at Pace Laboratory. Since we are guests at our access has been unpredictable, try to schedule a scan session for Saturday. Be back when confirmed. Okay. Happy to hear your headaches have become less frequent. Your latest test shows your brain is slowly recovering, but it's still too early to tell how well it will adjust to the damage. The bleeding will continue over the coming months. At least you need to come to the hospital a few times to drain the cavity to prevent the blood from building up pressure. It's excessive stress could be fatal. I have written you a prescription for prazosin to help you with your nightmares. Please read the instructions and medicate accordingly. Try to get a lot of rest, and I will see you next week.
Oh, I forgot to hit send.
Huh, you moron. Okay.
Better late than never.
The consoles remind me a lot of the way Doom 3 did consoles. And actually, I like the way they were done in that game. Can't believe all this time I didn't think to check in the medicine cabinet. Kind of the obvious place for medicine prescriptions or whatever.
There it is.
Caution, radioactive liquid. Okay. Let's drink it.
Feels like milk, but the taste, it's like sucking on a penny.
Yeah, that's never good. I know what pennies taste like because I was a kid once and I used to suck on pennies and other change. Doesn't taste too good. But then again, radioactive fluid probably doesn't taste good either. Okay. Oh. What's on TV?
Right. Watching TV gives me headaches now. Thank you, brain.
Massive recoil. Very appropriate. Okay. What's this? My keys. Probably don't need that. Let's go for a walk.
Jesse.
Hey, Simon. I got your email. Just wanted to wish you good luck and let you know I got you covered.
Thanks. I should be able to come to the store after the scan.
Don't sweat it. I got Matt and Chris helping me out.
Maddie from SNL?
Guess you didn't hear. He's coming in full time, working in the comic section.
That's Ashley's job.
Yeah. Well.
Forget it. Not doing her any favors by leaving an empty spot. I don't think she's coming back.
Well, good luck. Hope they find a way to reverse the whole, dying thing.
Dying thing? You're the worst support ever.
What should I say?
I'll see you later, Jesse. Don't burn the place down while I'm gone.
Over and out, buddy.
We'll find me a cold booth. I'll be set up.
Not a whole lot I could do there except just listen to what was going on around me. This is probably going to be like a big cutscene for a while. Even these
Hello?
Playable areas are more like
Dr. Munchie?
Hey, Okay, lights.
Where is everyone?
Good.
I thought this place would be busy.
Hey, we're in Canada. Or are we? Yeah, we are. CN Tower, cool. I live in Canada. I live in Toronto. That is so weird that I happen to be playing a game that opens in my city. It's like I know exactly where I am, too. Very weird. But also cool. Found some extra time in the lab today. Unfortunately, nobody told us about the code change, so I called security, talked to Professor Wei, and had him vouch for our project. Finally got a hold of some honcho over at Pace Legal Department that could re-grant us permission to use the lab. I'm not allowed to repeat the code in mails or text, but I'll leave a note or something in case we forget. Alright, so I gotta find a note with a key code on it. Da-da-da-da. This looks weird. Wow. So, according to these emails, this Simon guy, who's me, is supposed to go in for a brain scan, but according to the company's emails, looks like the two guys who run this place are trying to scam the Simon guy, because they don't even know how to use the equipment. And they want to use Simon as a lab rat or something. That's what it looks like. So, that's pretty sketchy. Alright, now I gotta find this note. Three six four. Do you think that could be it? Not likely. No. Oh, come on. Where do you leave a note? That's probably it. It's either 2501 or 2507. Booyah. Let's just make sure I didn't forget anything before I leave. I notice the graphics are not too great for this time period. I mean, 2015 and all, kind of expect better, but at the same time, I'm not the kind of person who's going to give the game a bad review because of graphics. It's really not that important if the game itself is excellent. But I just thought I'd point it out. It could simply mean that they were focusing on gameplay and making an immersive story. Which would be nice. Okay, that's good. Server room, maybe? Computer room? There's anything in here I can really use. Okay.
Oh, hi. Didn't hear you come in. Simon Jarrett, right?
Dr. Munchie?
Well, it's just Mr. Munchie, but I'm working on it. Actually, you're helping me right now.
Is this part of your thesis work?
Yeah. It's a study I'm doing with my colleague, Paul Berg. We hope to design a gentle way to work with brain reconstruction, to help people like you. Oh, did you, take the tracer fluid?
Yes. Yes, I did.
Great. Well, we can start whenever you're ready.
Huh. So this guy's feeding me some bullshit about, how he's doing some sort of a project or a thesis or whatever. But really, he's just messing around with my brain. He's probably gonna kill me.
Please, have a seat.
Yeah.
Come on, let's do this.
So, what exactly are we doing?
We're going to do a scan of your brain. Then we build a computer model of it and bombard it with stimuli. The program will help us to quickly iterate your treatment plan until it's fully optimized. In short, develop the perfect treatment for your condition.
So it's not just a study, this will actually help me.
I should hope so. Otherwise, this would be a huge waste of time.
Well, in the name of science, let's do it.
Let me just get this out of the way. You are Simon Jarrett, correct?
Right.
Toronto, Canada, Munchie. Born 1988, July 16.
Right.
Flat neurograph, version 6. Good. All files in order.
Will this hurt?
It's just a scan. It'll hurt about as much as getting your picture taken.
Indians thought cameras would steal their souls.
Is that so? Well, let's hope they're wrong. Ready? Say cheese.
I have a sneaking suspicion I'm going to wake up in a completely different place.
Hello?
Yep.
Mr. Munchie? Did something go wrong? This isn't funny!
Nice if I had a light or something.
I'm not supposed to put myself in... This is kind of stressing me out!
How did I get here?
Okay.
I can figure this out. I just need to stay calm. I need to make things worse.
Omni-tool. Okay, I don't have an Omni tool. Gonna be that easy. Service console. Where's the service console? Oh, that was back where the Omni tool thing was. Yeah, I don't have an Omni tool. Where do I find one? Toolbox. Maybe I could break the glass. Looks like it's going to be a bit harder. Ah. Can't believe I didn't think of this before. Bingo. Just like the one I was in. Oh! No. It is the room I was in. I don't know if I want to open that door yet. So, washer. And some kind of a kitchenette. See that? Some goo coming out of the ceiling. Actually, on Frictional Games' website, they've got some media advertising this game. And if you read all the archives, there's something in there about this goo. It's got some sort of plot significance, but I can't remember exactly what it was. Let's go open that door. Oh, wait a minute.
It's looking better than expected. They're having a really hard time getting the doors open.
Call Permisil as many as you can. Rather than take any chances.
Roger. Did you call for the factory floor?
Hold up. Just keep us on up. I'm on my way to lock off the comms tower.
Just make sure to leave a way out of here.
Trust me, I'm considered a data safe and sell. We just need to make sure we're leaving enough power, right, so we don't have to return.
I hear that. See you back if you can.
Magic. Okay, let's say we open that door that had the growling coming from it. I guess that effect, that scrambling effect, happens when you see a robot or some sort of an enemy, maybe.
Yeah, you do. So weird.
What was that? Whatever it was, it didn't sound good. So, that voice referred to something called structure gel, which I can only assume is that goo that was dripping from the ceiling. Must be important to maintain these robots or something. Wasn't this closed a minute ago? This was. That goo. Omni tool. Advanced interface for accessing, managing, and controlling computerized systems. Outboard intelligence includes an open set of behaviors and protocols to enable the user to automate routine actions, basic logical charts, blah 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 blah. Automatically adapt these programs, okay. Short range signal useful for basic automated actions such as opening doors. Connecting to a workstation or terminal. Applied operators into the exit slot. Slot has a standard connector which allows the user to get these market cortex chips. Huh. Okay. Cool. Right. So now I have an Omni tool. Should I go back to where I started and use it, or? Well, this is a dead end anyway, so I guess I should. Alright, let's head back.
Service console up to 30, including pilot seat activated.
Okay, system status. Servers offline, main power suspended. Program unreliable. Emergency systems 13 days. Okay, great. So I've got 13 days to win the game or live or whatever. Reprogress. S6 scan. SJ. Ah, that's me. Theta cache. Simon Jarrett. Terminal scan. David Munchie. Authority. David Munchie. 2015. Toronto. The heck? Apps. Operation. Unavailable. Operation. Omnitool. Welcome back, Louise. Where are you? Your Omnitool is in perfect condition. Not fitted with a tool chip. Without a tool chip, your FST kit will be unavailable, including your cross-site security access. If you're using your designated privileges, please insert a tool chip and run an update. Okay, Cortex chip. Okay. Being serviced by the default onboard intelligence helper, Jane. Note that installing a Cortex chip will override the helper and may severely alter your user experience. Okay, something opened next to me. Probably some goodies.
I know they told you the field technicians would get full access throughout Pesos 2. I'm here to tell you that's not going to happen. Don't get me wrong, I don't want to get in your way. We need you guys to keep this place up and running, but there needs to be at least some level of security on these things. I don't want to hear you barge to some quarantined area at Omicron and just knocked out the whole place with some virus, or whatever the hell they're doing over there. This is what you can do. You'll be able to use it to open doors, basically all of them. If you can't, there's something wrong or someone didn't want you in there. Then what do? You shove that Omnitool into a terminal and see if you can't get around it somehow. I mean, sometimes you'll need to get into places where you don't belong. Just find a way. You're an engineer for crying out loud. What else? Take care of your gear. Don't be an asshole. That's about it, really.
Nice.
My name is John Strohmeyer, Pesos 2 security operative. I got an office with Dan. Come see me if you got any issues you can't handle yourself. Good luck.
Okay, so two pieces of information from that little orientation that are important. One, don't be an asshole. Two, go to Theta if you have any kind of technical issues like opening doors or whatever. Because there's most likely going to be something there that can help me. Okay. Sounds good. Now where the hell is that thing that opened next to me? It sounded like it came from here. Oh. What's this?
Tool chip
found. Tool chip. Nice. Okay. Tool chip.
Tool chip security cipher updated.
God, I love that voice. Sweet. The other thing that's really cool too is the sounds it makes when it's like reading stuff. It sounds like an old floppy drive and I love that. Believe it or not, I still have a hard drive on my computer. A floppy drive, I mean. Yeah, I know they went out of date like a gajillion years ago, but I still find a use for them. They're cool. Apparently they're cool in Soma too. Okay, now what do I do? This is the bathroom. I was already here. This is the kitchen. I was already here too. Being open before. Unfortunately, I don't see a handle or an access panel or anything like that, so dead end. Happens, I freak out and have to run for my life. Okay, what's this? I wasn't actually serious, I wasn't trying to touch it. I didn't even press a key or anything, I just sort of walked into it. See a light in the distance. disturb before. Okay, this is new. Maybe now would be a good time to take a break. So I'm gonna cut the video here, and when I play again, we can continue on from this point. Looks like a different area anyway, so it's probably a logical place to start a new chapter. Anyway, thanks for watching, and I'm definitely going to continue this video series.